So for the last 11 years at Gowling WLG, my practice has been predominantly intellectual property law. And it's a very diverse area, but I practice in patent litigation, trademark prosecution, copyright and trademark enforcement. And on the trademark side, my clients can range from a small business down the street from our office to large multinational corporations or scientists and researchers doing research at the university level or private industry level. So I do really enjoy getting to work with a wide variety of companies and clients, and the subject matter is very diverse as well. One day I may be working on a new biotechnology case, and the next day it may be apparel and trademark work. One of the things that I particularly enjoy, especially in the patent litigation realm, is the ability to have one foot in the scientific community and one foot in the legal community. This brings me to why I came into law, but I came into law with a science background. I did a life sciences undergraduate and then began research as a cancer researcher in a microbiology lab. And through doing the research, I had a whole new appreciation of the research level and the scientific drug discovery level. And I wanted to be able to combine that background with something like law. So when I did go to law school, I had my eye on doing intellectual property at the same time. And through law school, I developed a new passion of advocacy, written and oral advocacy. I joined a number of competitive moots in law school, which was a fantastic experience and really sparked me to get into the litigation pathway. Communication with clients is something that I do on a daily basis, and my main rule of thumb is that no two clients are the same. So what might work for one client and be ideal for one client may not work for another client. And so I've really learned over the years to, when you're communicating with clients, reporting to clients, to check in and make sure that the way you're reporting or the instructions that you're seeking are done in a way that works for them. Because as I said, that there's many different types of clients, there's many different personalities that have different preferences, and so getting that feedback from clients in terms of how they like to communicate with you, whether it be face-to-face in meetings, by email most of the time, and how involved they want to be in the case is I think a key to communication is getting that feedback from clients. One of the big trends that we're noticing right now is companies and businesses going global and going international and wanting that seamless coordination of their international activities. And this doesn't necessarily apply just to the large multinational corporations, but also small business owners want access to markets like China and Europe and around the world. And having merged with a European firm now, and Gowling WLG, having that international presence, it's really nice to be able to pick up the phone and speak with a colleague in my UK office or our European offices or in China and get a quick answer for a client or coordinate around the globe their international and business activities and provide access to clients to these markets through either Hamilton, Ontario or Vancouver, BC. So we're seeing that trend globally and trying to coordinate and provide that seamless service to our clients to reach out to around the globe and connect clients with our firms elsewhere.